An OpenStreetMap Mapathon is a way to bring people together to work on improving OpenStreetMap. Mapathons are often known for humanitarian efforts, like the Missing Maps Project, where volunteers and humanitarian groups map out vulnerable areas before a disaster or crisis occurs, to reduce risk and help speed recovery. At a Mapathon, participants work on a mapping task that a humanitarian group has asked for help with, by tracing buildings and roads from satellite images. The humanitarian organizations and local groups then use that map data in the field, adding details and creating maps. Having better maps before a crisis will help emergency responders, aid groups, and the communities themselves. Hosting a Mapathon is fun, and you don't have to be an expert at OpenStreetMap to do it. Here's how to host one. First, you'll need a venue. Meeting rooms at libraries or community centers are good places, and sometimes universities, schools, and companies can offer rooms too. You'll probably want to have a big room in case lots of people show up, and good Wi-Fi that will be able to handle a lot of people connecting at the same time. Make sure to test the Wi-Fi ahead of time. Nothing stalls a Mapathon like slow Wi-Fi. It's also a good idea to reach out to Missing Maps as soon as you started to think about hosting Mapathon. The folks at Missing Maps can suggest a mapping task to work on, and they may be able to provide someone to talk about the mapping task. Missing Maps can also provide resources like training and guidance, tabletop quick reference guides, publicity materials, and a lot more. They're here to help. It's also a good idea to see if there are OpenStreetMap experts in your area who'd like to help out. Try wiki.openstreetmap.org, or just do a web search for OpenStreetMap in your area. Often the local mapping community is happy to help out, as tutors during the event or organizers ahead of time. The Humanitarian OpenStreetMap team's YouTube page also has a number of tutorial videos where you can learn more about editing OpenStreetMap. You should start doing outreach early on, too. Publicize your event through social media and through any groups that might be interested. Student groups, tech meetups, and volunteer organizations are a good start. Using a website like Eventbrite or something similar is a good way to track who is attending. You also need plenty of extension cords and outlets so people can plug in their laptops. Some extra computers can be good for those who don't have their own as well. If the venue has someone who can do tech support, make sure you have their contact info. A projector can be useful too, to show people specific things, give some tutorials, or just to talk about what you're seeing on the map. You'll want some friends and volunteers to help with planning, organizing, and running the event too. Maybe three or four folks who can walk around and help people as they're mapping, plus someone to perform other organizing functions, like greet and register people as they arrive, or take pictures and run social media. A registration table and name tags are a good idea too. Snacks are also important. If there's pizza, drinks, or sandwiches, people will likely stay longer and do more mapping. Red Cross staff often joke that pizza fuels their mapping. On the day of the event, you want to make sure you arrive early to set up the room, the registration table, name tags, brochures, training materials, and the tabletop quick reference guides and extension cords. This may seem like a lot, but they're all important steps. And remember that dozens of groups from student organizations, volunteer groups, companies, and more have done their own mapathons. MissingMaps.org has a number of checklists and guides for you to use in organizing your mapathon. And they're always willing to help. Feel free to reach out to them. And the last thing to remember is the most important one. Have fun.